Hello everyone, and welcome back. It's been a real rough week at work. I'm glad it's Friday and back up to the farmhouse. Between working in the cold, because it was a cold week, we had days where we were down into like 14 degrees in the morning with a high of 29. And now it's nice, it's up to like 34. And I think tomorrow it's gonna get into the low 40s, but it's gonna be windy tomorrow. But anyway, I'm glad this work week is done. Back up to the farmhouse. We'll have to see where the weekend takes us. If you guys watched the last short video that I put up, you know that we picked up some roosters. They made it up here a few days ago and they seem to have just fit right in. It's amazing how the two came from the same coop, so they don't fight together. And the hens just accepted it right away. It was, there was no fighting at all. I've got the wood stove going out in the workshop. I'm just warming it up tonight. I want to start it right away early in the morning tomorrow and get it kind of heated up. My dad is coming up here. He's supposed to be up here about 8:30 in the morning. He needs to get some Diamond Willow, which is actually this kind of tree right here, or bush, whatever you want to call it. He's making a desk for his house, and it's going to be a real rustic desk, and he has some Diamond Willow, which he usually gets up by the cabin or up by the tent, but he doesn't have enough. And several places on the property here, we have a lot of it. This is quite an old one, with pretty big on the bottom. Something would be too big for what he's looking for, but they call it Diamond Willow because it gets these little like diamond shapes in it, and when you peel it, it looks really neat, and it has some pretty nice color to it. There's another good example right there. So I've got the stove running tonight. I'm gonna run it for just a few hours. With the workshop, with all the cement in here, if you can get that heated up at night, you come out here in the morning, it'll already be, 40, 45 degrees. So then when I started early, it won't take as long to warm it up, because I'm sure we'll end up in the workshop for a little while. We have one sick cat that Melissa brought in to the vet earlier this week, and they did blood work on it. And they thought that it might be its like thyroid or something. Anyway, it's Runny the cat. We've had it forever, and I call him the most loving, annoying cat. He's always wanting to rub against you and jump up on you. And he's an outside cat. We've got it inside in a kennel right now. And anyway, did the blood work, and the blood work came back today, and it said that there's absolutely nothing wrong with Runny. And Runny looks like he's ready for death's door. So the vet said, can you please bring him in on Saturday morning? They want to run a whole new set of blood work after he has fasted for 12 hours. So now no food or water for 12 hours. They'll pull blood in the morning. And hopefully they can figure out what's wrong with Runny. And then we have some sad news. 2 days ago, doe number two, or Honey Bunny, as Melissa named the rabbit, passed away. So, I mean, she was lucky to have Melissa take care of her the last 6 weeks, because she was very old and very sickly, and it was her time. So she is gone now, and now next year Melissa and I may get a pair of rabbits. They're just kind of fun to have around, and they're nice to have around in case something happens. If you have a male and a female, it's a quick food source once you start breeding those rabbits. It's amazing. Well, I think I'm going to run inside for a while now. I might want to pull the tractor out too. I'd like to get that filled with oil, get some gas in it. Do a few things, because next weekend is opening deer hunting. So, I'm going to be gone for a few days there. Okay everyone, well, it's almost 10 o'clock, 70 degrees in here, 29 outside.
Melissa and I are just about to go to bed, so I came out here to load up the stove. And both of us have to be up pretty early tomorrow.
Good morning, everybody. That wind has really picked up out there overnight. I mean, I heard it was going to be windy today, but I didn't think it would be this windy this early. It won't be long, it'll be time for ice fishing.
Well, Melissa just left with Runny, going to the vet. And now I'm just waiting for my dad to show up. Well, if we can get this one fixed, this is so nice because this one's going to want to do we load wood in here. This has to stay on this one. So, yeah. I might take the other rack that's on the other one and put it on George's old, because this is the one that I like to just buzz around with because I don't care if I over something.
Oh, I see.
That's
nice.
Yep. The other one runs on winch, but this will be nice for 2 or 3 inches of snow, and, unless it's 10 inches or something.
Yeah, you can just cut any piece of wood or anything, not nothing to rub up, like you
can. I find that the ones here, you have to look for them to have that. They don't have as many as up north.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Right,
this one is, that's all they have to be good in it.
Yeah, we've got some.
My dad left for home. We got a, you guys saw a whole bunch of Diamond Willow for him. And Melissa guy is back now, and I'm running into the store. I wanted to get a couple of things at L&M. She's gonna make breakfast for lunch. I'm pretty excited about that. We haven't had that for a while. And we're going to, she's gonna make hash browns this time too. Well, I got everything I needed from L&M. To the liquor store, and now I'm heading back to the farmhouse. Smells good in here.
Yeah.
Well, I got a new latch for the workshop door because what happens is all I have is a barrel like one of these on there, but a smaller one. And first of all, when I do it, as the winter things move, it doesn't want to latch really good. Right now it's already giving me trouble. It drives me crazy. And what'll happen is if I take the four, like say I come in here and then I have a little eye hook that locks it on the inside, then I go out the back door and get the four wheelers and take those out. And then I come around to come into the workshop and the door is locked. I have to go all the way around. So, and it happens both directions. So I got one of these and I hope, like normally this should be on the inside, but it would work better for me if it was on the outside, the way that the door is set up, because the door now, there's like a board here and then the door hits against it. So it sticks into the room here. So I'll have to play around with it and see what I can do. If not, or whatever, I can, this is bigger, so I'll have more room to slide that in. And then I got, I don't know how many pounds of different size bolts, because remember the other day, I didn't have the right size for the four-wheeler, so I'll have to separate all these. I think I've got 8 different types in there. I think I'll run in and see if lunch is ready. I can't get this one to work. It said that it's three quarter to 2.5 inch door. That door is about 2 11/16, so we're about 3/16 shy. But even if I go and do this, the way they're saying it at 2.5, it's like, no way. 2 3/8 is closer. I mean, 2.5 would probably work, but you wouldn't want to put much strain on it. And I can chip out more of that plywood, but I only have this much room to work with until this is hitting the wood, and I'm not going to score the whole thing out. They said, it says on here that they do make one. It's also available for a 3-inch thick door. I'll just have to find one. They did not have one of those at L&M, so I'll have to go to Menards or something and find a different lock. For now, I'm just going to put the bigger barrel lock on the barrel, whatever it's called, on there, and that'll be better than what I had. I would have put the camera outside there, but that wind is just nasty. Temperature isn't bad, it's 42 degrees, but that wind will gust really hard, and it just does not feel like a nice day out there. Well, tractor is full of oil. It's got about 3/4 of a tank of gas. I didn't have, remember last winter, the tractor wasn't in here all winter. It wasn't in here for any of the cold part of the winter. So I have no power to run out this far to plug in the heater on here to keep the water warm and the whole engine warm when it gets super cold. So I ran that cord out that I used to run for the fifth wheel. And then you guys saw I had to do some modifications to get it through the wall. Come up here and I have a plug-in. I've got one lamp so I can kind of see what I'm doing. And a cord set up right there. And right here is the plug-in for the heater, which is right there. So I should be all set up here when it gets super cold.
been having a problem with this little chainsaw. Like when I was up duck hunting, it'll start quitting, and then I could like open up the gas cap. You know, you just try different things, like is it an airlock? Do they even have airlock anymore like when I was a kid? I don't know. And then it would work. So, but I warmed it up in here today and it seems to start just fine. I mean, it hasn't been used that much, so it's probably user error. What I really need is a day to clean up the workshop in here, but right now it's what, Saturday night? So 1 week from today, the first day of deer hunting 2020 will be done. We'll be up at the tent. And I really think that I accomplished quite a bit today, just the little things that need to be done. I mean, I am ready for winter now. I have enough lumber now for sure. We've got the door that was the front door in the house, so I can finally replace that back wall right there in the workshop. Get that moved back about a foot. That's gonna be really nice also. Bought a palm sander. I did not have one up here. We've got them at work, and I didn't have anything in this workshop. I've got one down at the hobby farm. Even the one I've got there is getting pretty old. So, and I really like these DeWalt ones. They're kind of expensive, but they last a long time. As soon as I get that new wall built and pushed back, then I'm going to have shelves in there to put the tools like this stuff, skill saw. I have nowhere right now to set tools, so everything gets set all over the place. Ready to go inside, huh? You want to go see Mama? All right, let's go. Okay, everyone. Well, I'm gonna go take a shower, and it's just about bedtime. It's nasty out here tonight. That wind is blowing, there's been snow showers, and it's cold. Good morning, everybody. It has remained nasty all night. It's 23 degrees out there right now, and that wind is still whipping. From now, they're forecasting it's going to be 60 degrees, which we have not seen in a long time. I can't believe it's this nasty today. Even up deer hunting, 50s, that's unheard of the last few years. I see my atomic clock. It's supposed to set itself for time, and right now we just had daylight saving, so that should read 6:58.
Well, it's in the afternoon now. It's a little bit after 2 o'clock. Today is Sunday, so that's the day that we clean the house really good, do the litter boxes. I had to clean out the cage the rabbit was in before, and Melissa's been making Salisbury steaks for dinner for tonight, so they're still cooking in there. I still hope to make it out here for a little while this afternoon. I want to just pick a few things up, start getting it cleaned up. Well, I got the tarps pulled out of the garden. I was unsure that was going to happen with the snow that came. And it's going to warm up this week, so these will, all the ice will get melted off of them and I can get them folded up and put into the workshop for winter. Come on, Joey. It's so quiet without that wind now. Okay, everyone. Well, thanks a lot for watching. I really don't know if I accomplished a lot this weekend or not. I guess I'll find out when I start editing. I will see you guys on the next video.